Now, this week is the yard site of Reb Gershon Lieberman's Zatzal. Reb Gershon Lieberman, there is a story with him. First of all, he was a multi-millionaire for many, many years. How did he become a millionaire? Living in France, not knowing a word of French, and the Hebrew that he spoke was not the normal Sfaradit like they speak in Eretz Yisrael. He spoke like a Glitziana Yid back in Europe, like Sidish Yid, Atu Oimer. He spoke La Mamish. It sounds funny to the Israelis. And the Moroccans that he taught spoke Hebrew. And that's the way he spoke, very different than them. And nobody seemed, he took over the world despite this, because he lived with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. He didn't go with Teva. He was in his own world. And it worked like wonders. He built yeshivas all over France, and he became a multimillionaire. In fact, he sent me a free ticket to come to France. I showed an interest, and it's interesting, when I came there, I was searching to find out about Navardig, and he used to speak about me in public. First of all, he built me up and built me up and built me up and built me up. Even though Navardi pushes down, but they know the score. They know how people love Kavod, and they play on it. They're always giving Kavod, always giving Kavod to everybody. Give Kavod. That's the life of a person. All Navardi is understand the rules of human nature. Give Kavod. Now they, for themselves, they don't go for that. They feel it's not worth it, because if you are living off the Kavod that people are giving you, you're in a lonely road, because it won't always happen. And when it doesn't happen, you'll be devastated, like Haman. Haman, he's scared, the whole world's bowing down to him. And as soon as one person, Mordechai, is not, he's going crazy. The more, in fact, they told me in the body that the more a person gets Kavod, the more in danger he is if it gets to his head. He's in a lot of danger, because then he can't tolerate not getting, he's so used to it. Some people, I witnessed people, the day after they were honored in public, they were animals. They weren't the same. They were snappy and mean and tough. What happened to you? Because the Kavod got to the head, even though they said they don't want Kavod. But meantime, when people give them Kavod, it gets to your head, and then anybody does something you don't like, you're ready to snap at them. You're not the same person. So getting Kavod ain't so simple, although I recommend when you get Kavod, like Rabbi Miller said, appreciate it. Thank Hashem for it. It's going to help you steig, because you're getting Kavod. It's going to make you move it. And the other hand, the Navardigas believe, go get the Kavod, but then learn Musa that Kavod is really hevel, or else you can run into trouble. So each person does what's good for him. But anyway, he gave me a lot of Kavod, Reb Gershon. He was very big into that. More and more Kavod, because he understood human nature, and I kept coming back there. I must confess, it wasn't for the Kavod. Dafka, I just wanted to see Reb Gershon, but it didn't mind. It certainly made me more comfortable. Reb Gershon was a smart man. Keep building up in public. And what he used to say, in front of all his Talmidim, this Yid came from Lakewood to be Mechazik us. Look at the psychology. The way, as if I'm came to be Mechazik then, that's Bechal not the reason why I came. But he wanted to make me feel good. So he kept saying, I came to be Mechazik. Then, I'll tell you another mitzvah with him. His psychology understood human nature very well. He had a Talmud who was not so, he was unruly. And the Talmud was not so, giving a lot of trouble, very wild, make a troublemaker. You know what he did with that Talmud? Talmud told me himself, in Lombardy, they don't mind smacking, no problem. They're the old school. They don't, and he gave this guy a smack. Anyway, the next day, He got the whole yeshiva together, and he made a shmuz in public, and he said, do you know I have pain all night because of the smack that I gave that bachur? HaKadosh Baruch Hu punished me for giving smack to that boy. And that boy was sitting there, he felt like $1 million. It changed his life. He became a new person because he saw how Reb Gershon respected him. And he said, look at this, I got punished from Shemayim because I smacked this boy. So That's a typical Navardiga midah, to be machnia and not and to put yourself down, not to be afraid of that stuff. It's just covered, and that's the way they built up other people. Now, I'm going to tell some more stories about Reb Gershon Lieberman since his yard site is coming up. There was a man that's like the most unusual human being. Forget about his Torah and Avodah. As a human being, he was totally happy. He was a happy person. The Altar for Navardig held that the Chadake Noyam is the aside of his whole Shita. If it doesn't go Gishmak, it's not Noyam, then you're off the Derech. Yiddishkeit has to be Gishmak. Of course, Chas v'Chalila, we're not reformed Jews that do whatever we want. That's not what it means. It means we go according to the system, but it's gotta be Gishmak. That's why it says when you pick a Torah, you're always saying Varevna, make it Gishmak. It's our job to make it, says Zekeli Van Vehu. And I will make him beautiful. It's the duty of every Jew to try to make his Yiddishkeit beautiful. Try to make a Gishmak, a Shabbos dish. Daven for it. Daven. When you meet people, you're going to a chasam. Always daven. Make it Gishmak. Make it Gishmak. You have a Musa Seder. Make a daven for it. Daven a lot. That your Yiddishkeit should always be Gishmak. The Altar from the body brings proofs that the Torah will not only accept things that are Gishmak. There's a Shailab, what is a Lulav, what is an Esrig, what is a Adasim, and there are certain possibilities of certain types of species, certain type of fruits that stick your hands. And the Gemara says that cannot mean what the Torah says. When the Torah says pre-Eitz Hadar, it does not mean a fruit like that, because that would hurt you. And the Torah would never give a mitzvah that's going to give you pain like that. And he has several riots like that. The Altar of Navardig, if it's giving pain, you're off the derech. And the whole Sefer Madrega Sa'adam is built on this principle that you want to have a good life, don't look for covet. You want to be happy? Now he goes in the opposite direction of the rest of the world. The Altar of Navardig noticed how people suffer because they need cover. That's the true source. He went down to the sheirish, the root of all unhappiness in this world. And he found all the unhappiness in the world comes from because people are not getting enough covet. Or whenever they get aggravation, even the frum reasons, they may have good reasons why they have aggravation. A child is chas v'shalom not frum enough, or whatever it is. In Navardi, they said, oh, no, 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 no. If that boy would be frum, but he wouldn't like you so much, you'd also have aggravation. Or if someone else who's not your child, you have the same type of aggravation when people go against you. Don't blame it on Yiddishkeit, because you're so frum. So therefore, it made life much easier for Navardi, because they were very truthful. They were vara than midas. They went to the root of what's really bothering you, and they used to find usually it's nothing more than covered, which is hevel havolim. And therefore, they would learn Musar a long time and keep repeating HaKavod Hevel HaVolim. And after a while, it wouldn't bother them the pain that was given to them from the rebellious child or the wife that's screaming at them or whatever it is. They would realize it's all covered, and we don't care about covered anyway. And if you have bezyanus, it's very good for you. And that's the way they worked. So, the Reb Gershon adored the Navardig Shita. He couldn't see, never always used to tell me how he loves the Shita of Navardig. Everything he was thanks to Navardig. And his happiness was unbelievable because he learned loads and loads of Musa. He brainwashed himself not to worry about COVID. He brainwashed himself not to worry about Parnosa, things like this. He learned lots and lots of Musa to brainwash yourself, and the thing that will make you a happy person, that's what he worked on all his life. And the thing that happened is not looking for cover. You're already happy. Without getting what you want, just don't you? People that have no idea how cover destroys them. They don't chop the root of all their problems. What are people going to say? My wife is this and my dad, or I'm not so smart, or I'm not so frum. And you're worried all day about what were people going to say. And they put a lot of kaychas in this area, and that's why they became so great and so super, super happy. I have a friend, Rabbi Yonason Blau, he told me that he was raised in Beis Yosef Nevardig in Borough Park, and he remembered hundreds of old Nevardigers who survived the war with all different kinds of terrorists. And he said the simcha level was extremely high by all of them. The Abish is al-Hom.